فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
The fifth one is al-jahala. Is he unknown? Is the narrated in the hadith unknown? Are you guys with me? Jahalatul ayn. Brothers, if the criticism of a narrator is due to his adala, then nothing that can help him. He's finished. The hifz and the memory, which is fuhshul ghalat. So he says to you, no brother, I'm talking about the memory. The criticism that is directed to him is one of the two. It's fuhshul ghalati. Aw su'ul hifzi. Aw al-ghaflati. Aw kathratul awhami. Aw mukhalafati thiqati. Those are the five in which he... So how many at-ta'alu fil rawi is how many times all together? When we got adalat and dabt, how much is it all together? Ten. Five each. So it's ten. And we have, so any hadith which a person asks you, it's weak. These are the, of course it has to be a person of hadith, not a general, anyone who, a lot of people just say it's weak hadith. You ask him why, he said, I don't know, but it's weak. We're talking about Aimatul Hadith. When they weaken the hadith, because of those. Ibn Hajar here now, he's going to start with the first type of which one? As-saqtu fi sanad. Which type of saqtu sanad is he going to talk about? Al-Zahir. Which is the first one of the Zahir that I mentioned? So we're going to start Mu'allaq now. Why is he going to start with Mu'allaq? Because Mu'allaq starts from the beginning of the chain of the narrator of the hadith. And he's going to make his way gradually up. Al-Mu'allaq. Na'am. So Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, he said, ثُمَّ الْمَرْدُودُ, the hadith which is rejected. Imma, it is because, أَنْ يَكُونَ, it's because it is لِسَقْطٍ, a disconnection. أَوْ طَعْنٍ, or a criticism. فَالسَّقْطُ, the disconnection, imma an yakunu, it's possible, it takes place what? Min mabda'i sanadi, from the beginning of the chain. Min musannafin, from the author of the book. Oh, I already told you what mu'allaq means now. It can happen from the beginning of the chain of the author of the book. Good. Aw min akhirihi, ba'da tabi'i. Or the ending, ba'da tabi'i, after the tabi'i. So it's the same, it's the beginning of the chain. Or غير ذلك or other than it. فالأول المعلق. Sorry. He said من مبدأ السند. It can be from the مبدأ السند. Which is what? Which is معلق. أو من آخر بعد التابعي. That's مرسل. And then أو غير ذلك or other than it is either معطل or منقطع. Those are the four types that I just mentioned. Pay attention now. We're going to start with the first one, which is mu'allaq. Mu'allaq is what? First of all, is an ism maf'ul in Arabic language. And it's from what? Min at-ta'liqi. It's from the word ta'liq. Allaq al-shay'a. Ta'liq means what, brothers? Learn this, okay? It's to hang something on top of a ceiling. It's to literally dangle something. That's called Arabic ta'liq. أناطه وربط بها وجعله معلقا وسمي هذا السند معلقا بسبب اتصال من الجهة العليا فقط. The reason why they call it معلق is because it's connected from the other side of the prophet side. Are you guys with me? But from after the bottom, there's nothing there. So the rope, when it dangles, it doesn't touch the floor, does it? It's dangling. So that part that's not touching the floor is the part which makes it معلق, right? So the سند is like that. It's معلق. ولذلك the 11 women that came and sat down and spoke to each other, who the hadith of Ummu Zara, one of the women, she said, "In antuq, if I speak about my husband, utallaq, he will divorce me. Wa in askut, and if I become silent, u'allaq, I'll just dangle. So if I speak about him and I say something about him, he will divorce me. He will hear it and he will divorce me. And if I'm silent, I'm basically like a woman that's not married, like." So I have no way out. If I speak about him and I criticize him, he will divorce me. If I what? If I try to be silent about it and not tell anyone about it, then I'm just basically a person who's living a rough life. I'm just dangling. So the word alaqa in Arabic, that's what it means. It means that. That's what it means linguistically. Technically, what does it mean? Ma hudifa. It is that which is, it's been taken, hidden. مِن مَبْدَئِ إِسْنَادِهِ, it is that the chain of narration, one person or more, وَلَوْ إِلَىٰ آخِرِ الْإِسْنَادِ, even if it's to the ending of the chain of narration, This is called mu'allaq. Don't worry, we're going to come to the types of ta'liq, how it comes, how it occurs in details. But what it means is that we're going to do its suwar, its forms, it comes in. Okay? We're going to take the forms, it comes in. It's only five forms. We're going to take it, inshallah ta'ala. Mu'allaq means, it is ma hudifa, anything. Hadf means, in Arabic, it means something that's removed. Deleted or taken, removed. Ma hudifa, it is to remove min mabda isnadihi, from the beginning of the chain. When we say the beginning, pay attention, brothers. We don't mean it from the Prophet's side. We mean it from the author of the book's side. So Bukhari's book, mathalan, or with Dawood's book. Any scholar who wrote a book, his side, his angle, from his teacher onwards, it's called mu'allaq. Okay? He removes that person. If it's one person, it's mu'allaq. If it's more than one person, it's also mu'allaq. Are you guys with me? Even if it's to the ending of the chain, is what? It's a mu'allaq. Okay? It's a mu'allaq. Ibn Salah, al-Nawawi and Iraqi, they said with the condition, it has to be majzum. It has to be done with siratul jazm, which we take a last lesson, that he has to narrate it, not with a siratul tamrid, siratul jazm, in order for it to be called mu'allaq. Iraqi says in his alfiyya, وَإِنْ يَكُونِ أَوَّلُ الْإِسْنَادِ حُذِفْ مَعْ صِيغَةِ الْجَزْمِ فَتَعْلِيقًا عُرِفْ وَلَوْ إِلَىٰ آخِرِهِ أَمَّا الَّذِي لِشَيْخِهِ عَزَايِبِ قَالَ فَاكِدِ عَنْ عَنَةٌ كَخَبَرِ الْمَعَازِفِ لَا تَسْغِ لِبْنَ حَزْمِ لِلْمُخَالِفِ. So Iraqi rahimahullah, he mentions that if it's at the beginning of the chain of the narration, مَعَ صِيغَةِ الْجَزْمِ, but it has to be narrated with the صِيغَةِ الْجَزْمِ, such as the word قَالَ, عَنْ, it can't be قِيلَ, رُوِيَ, يُحْكَ, يُذْكَر, all of that is صِيغَةُ التَّمْرِيضِ. They don't know that as a mu'allaq. وَلِذَلِكَ عِرَاقِ, look what he refuted even in that part of the hadith. عَنْ عَلَةٌ كَخَبَرِ الْمَعَازِفِ. What's the عَنْ عَلَةٌ كَخَبَرِ الْمَعَازِفِ? The story is the hadith of the music. عَنْ عَلَةٌ, عِرَاقِ is refuting. He said, لَا تُسْخِي لِبْنِ حَزْمٍ الْمُخَالِفِ. Ibn Hazm, don't give an attention to what he said. Don't bring your ear close to his speech. I mean, it has no weight. It's not right. It's incorrect. Iraqi, rahimahullah, he said it in his 1,000 lines of poetry, rahimahullah. So, the word ta'liq means what? It means that something that's dangling. If you call a woman mu'allaqa, it means a woman that's not married, that's not divorced. She's a mu'allaq. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said about the woman, and وَلَنْ تَسْتَطِعْ أَنْ تَعْدِلُ بَيْنَ النِّسَاءِ وَلَوْ حَرَصْتُمْ. You'll never be able to give all your wives their rights as much as you try. فَلَا تَمِيلُوا كُلَّ الْمَيْلِ فَتَذَرُوهَا كَالْمُعَلَّقَةِ. فَلَا تَمِيلُوا, do not turn towards one of the women so much that the other one becomes what? كَالْمُعَلَّقَةِ, like she becomes a mu'allaq. See, ta'liq, mu'allaq. She's dangling, you're not married to her and you're not divorcing her. You see, Allah orders in the Quran, the way we married to the woman is what? إِمْسَاكُمْ بِمَعْرُوفِ أَوْ تَسْرِيحٌ بِإِحْسَانِ. Be married to her in good, or let the girl go. Not in between. You see? Okay. So we learned what? The word ta'liq, what it means, we've learned it. Suwar al-mu'allaq. The forms that mu'allaq comes in. This is very important that you learn it. It comes in five ways, inshallah. The first way it comes in is أَن يُحْذَفَ جَمِيعُ السَّنَدِ. The whole of the chain of narration is disconnected. خلاص. All of it. مَعَ إِضَافَةِ الْقَوْلِ إِلَىٰ قَائِلِهِ. But with the condition of what? Ascribing to the speech of the person who said it. So for example, Chef Ibn Bukhari would say what? قَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ. What has he dropped? His teacher and everyone in the chain of narration. But he's ascribed the speech to the owner of the speech, which is the Prophet. Are you guys with me? Good. That's the first one. Remember, it always has to be from the beginning of the chain. The second one is, أَنْ يَحْذَفَ أَنْ يُحْذَفَ, that it's removed, جَمِيعُ السَّنَدِ مَعَ عَدَمِ إِضَافَةِ الْقَوْلِ إِلَىٰ قَائِلِهِ. The speech is not ascribed to the individual who said it. The second one is, the speech is not ascribed to the person who said it. The whole of the chain of is corrected. The third one is what? أَنْ يَحْذَفَ, that it's removed, جَمِيعُ السَّنَدِ, all of the chain of narration, إِلَّا الصَّحَابِيُّ, except the companion is not removed. So So he says, قال رسول الله. بخاري مثلا يسي عن أبي موسى الأشعري رضي الله تعالى عنه قال قال رسول الله. بخاري, all of these chains is missing. Why? Where is it gone? Are you with me? Four. أن يحذف جميع السندي. That he removes all of the chain of narration. إلا الصحابي. Except the صحابي. والتابعي. And also the تابعي. The fifth one is what? The fifth one is أن يحذف من حدثه. He only removes the person who told him. He removes the person who told him. ويضيف إلى من فوقه. And anyone after that he mentions it. He just drops out his teacher and after that he mentions it. He drops out his teacher and he just mentions after the person his teacher. Here, those are the examples in Sahih al-Bukhari. Go to Hadyu Sari, the introduction of Ibn Hajar rahimahullah, in which he talks about how Ibn Bukhari wrote his book. And you see, he talks about it there. Pay attention. وَلَيْسَ مِنْ سُوَرِ الْمُعَلَّقِ. It is not from the forms of mu'allaq مَا عَزَاهُ الْمُؤَلِّفِ. That which a teacher ascribes to, a student ascribes to, author of the book ascribes to his teacher by saying قَالَ. If a teacher ascribes to his teacher and he says قَالَ, his sheikh said, even though the word قَالَ isn't meant to be used because it's meant to be used حَدَّثَنِي أَخْبَرَنِي to make it clear that he heard it from him. But if a student such as Bukhari uses the word قَالَ of his own teacher, this is not, it's not from the forms of mu'allaq. حُكْمُهَا, its ruling is what? حُكْمُ الْمُعَنْعَنْ. This takes the ruling of the mu'an'an, an'anatun. An'an'an'an. And that's what Ibn Iraqi رحمه الله mentioned. That's what Iraqi رحمه الله said. وَإِنْ يَكُنْ أَوَّلُ الْإِسْنَادُ حُدِفْ مَعْ صِيغَةِ الْجَزْمِ فَالتَّعْلِيقًا عُرِفْ ولو إلى آخره أما الذي لشيخه عزاه بقال فاكري عن عانة كخبر المعازف. Like the issue of the music, it's not given معلق لأن هشام بن عمار is from the شيوخ of Imam al-Bukhari and Bukhari used the word قال. So here is given what? قال of Ibn Bukhari رحمه الله is given the ruling of عن as though he used the word عن. If the hadith is narrated with عن from a narrator, scholars look at it with two things. First of all is what? لقاء الراوي لمن روى عنه. That this person had met this person in which he used the word قال for. Did Bukhari meet Hisham ibn Ammar? Yes, he did. Good. Second condition they look at is that سلامة الراوي من التدليس. That the person is safe from what? تدليس. To use the word what? For him to organize, which we're going to take in details inshallah what تدليس means in more details, inshallah. We're going to take it. What's the ruling of a hadith which is mu'allaq? What's the ruling of a hadith which is mu'allaq? Al-hadith al-mu'allaq da'if. The hadith which is mu'allaq is weak. Why? لأنه فقد شرطاً من شروط القبول. Because it is missing a condition from the conditions of acceptance of hadith. Which was what? Oh, ittisal al-sanad. Which is the connection of the chain of narration is missing. Okay? Because a narrator is missing, or even more than a narrator is missing. And we as, or the people of hadith, they require to know who is the person who's missing or what is his situation like. They want to know who is this person. But that being the mu'allaq, being weak and not being accepted and rejected, is as long as it's not in a book which conditions authenticity. As long as it's not in a book that conditions authenticity. If a book, في كتاب اشترط الصحة, if a book who conditioned authenticity narrates it, scholars have looked at it in a different angle. Such as, for example, which are two books, التزمت الصحة. They conditioned that their book is going to be authentic. Bukhari and Muslim. Bukhari and Muslim. They have a specific ruling. Them two, they have a unique ruling. Generally, the mu'allaq is rejected because it's disconnected. Like in these two books, la. It's different. The scholars, they say that their situation is two. The hadith which are mu'allaq, which are in Sahihain, Bukhari and Muslim, they cannot be, they're in one of these two camps. Okay? in one of these two terms. For example, ما كان معلقا. The hadith is معلق. It's معلق in the book. وجاء موصولا في الكتاب نفسه. But in the, so the author, such as Imam al-Muslim or Imam al-Bukhari, at the beginning, he brings the hadith معلق here. But in another place, he brings it موصول. A lot of times what you find is, موصول means connected. He brings it connected at the beginning and in the middle. Generally, he does that. He doesn't bring it later with the chain again. Why? Because tikrar and i'ada all the time, there's not significance. Are you guys with me? So he narrates it here, Mosul, gives you the chain of narration. Halfway in the book, he narrates it with the chain of narration disconnected. Okay? وَهَذَا هُوَ الْكَثِيرُ الْغَالِبُ عَلَى مُعَلَّقَاتِ الصَّحِيحِينَ. And that's the majority of the hadith which are in Bukhari and Muslim. The majority. That is one. If the second one is, مَا لَمْ يُوجَدْ إِلَّا مُعَلَّقًا. We can't find this hadith in the whole book. We check the book, and we can't find it mu'allaq anywhere in the book. In any other place. The scholars, they say, okay, now there's two situations regarding this one now. We looked for it. This hadith, Muslim, he only narrated a mu'allaq in his book. Are you guys with me? Who has more mu'allaq, Bukhari or Muslim? Bukhari has more mu'allaq. Bukhari has more mu'allaq than Muslim. Bukhari has more mu'allaq than Muslim. Okay? Pay attention. Pay attention. If ما لم يوجد إلا معلقا, we looked for it in the Sahih al-Bukhari or we looked for it in Sahih al-Muslim and we could not find it except معلقا through the whole of the book. Here, it has two ways we deal with it. If he narrated it بصيغة الجزم, he narrates it with the word روى, ذكر, حكى. We'll say here صيغة الجزم صحيح. If he narrated with صيغة الجزم, فهذا الصيغة يستفاد منها الصحة إلى من علق عنه. We'll say that he now has narrated the hadith, showed authenticity to whoever he has ascribed it to. The second one is, if he narrates it بصيغة التمريض, by saying رويا ويروى ويذكر ويقال. This, for example, the scholars, they said, authenticity and weakness is not taken from it. All that can be taken from it is according to the author of the book. He sees it weak, but it's not necessarily going to be weak. This one, what does it require? We will say this one. We need to do a research and find in other books whether they are authentic. So there has to be a little bit of research. So the scholars would go and they research, they'll find it either weak and they'll follow the author of the book, where he just said, or they'll find it authentic in other works and in other places. Now, so the ahadith which are mu'allaq, the way it's dealt with in Bukhari and Muslim should be known, distinct and different. And other books also should be known and the ruling of it. Na'am. والثاني, the second type, which is والثاني المرسل. The second one is المرسل. عراقي said رحمه الله مرفوع تابع على المشهور مرسل أو قيده بالكبير أو سقط راوي منه ذو أقوال والأول الأكثر في استعمال. مرسل اسم مفعول, اسم مفعول من الإرسال, اسم مفعول from إرسال. وأصله originally من قولهم, is from the speech of the Arabs where they say أرسل الشيء, to send something. أطلقه freed it. وأهمله forsaked it. And Allah says in the Quran, ألم ترى أن, do you not see, أن أرسلنا الشياطين على الكافرين, that we sent the shayateen to the disbelievers. أن أرسلنا الشياطين على الكافرين تؤزهم أزا. اصطلاحا, what does it technically mean? اصطلاحا is means ما رفعه التابعي. It is that which a tabi'i ascribes to the messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Even if a companion narrates from another companion, it's also called mursal. If a companion narrates from another companion, it's also called mursal. Mursal is a topic which in reality that has brought a lot of problems and a lot of خلافات.